Professor Matt Liberatore, and we are going to answer the question, what is a YouTube problem? Well, we start with the brain. And let's start with how the brain and the senses interact. And what we find is that sight, vision, trumps the other senses when we talk about learning, as well as developing short and long-term memory. So for centuries, professors have lectured. They have used their voice and their presence to help students learn and absorb the material, so very professor-centered. And in the 21st century, we have recorded these lectures and put them on platforms like YouTube. You can think of Khan Academy as one example. In chemical engineering, you may talk about the AICH Academy or LearnChemy.com that have come along in recent years in my area of expertise. But they're all expert-directed videos that end with the hope of helping students learn. However, students learn by doing. The field of active learning documents how better engagement and learning occur using techniques where students are at the center. And YouTube problems are a student-centered technique. What we do is we create new visual problems that are written by the students for almost any course. My expertise in chemical engineering, middle school science, we'll see some examples. But we're not going to learn how to create or edit or post videos online. We're going to instead reverse engineer the videos. So instead of breaking down what is a YouTube problem and going into it, let's just work on a problem together. So the scenario in this problem is snow collapsing the roof of a football stadium for playing American football. So a very large stadium holding tens of thousands of people. Here I just have a screenshot of it in class. I would show the video. And that video is creating some connections for the students. And it provides real-world context. In this problem, we call it an engineering estimate. The snow collapsing the Metrodome is the real-world setting. And we ask two questions. What are the mass and what is the volume of the snow entering the Metrodome after it collapsed? And so in class, I let students use their devices to solve the problem. After some amount of time, my students turn in these estimates. And although students working in groups usually of three or four are not confident in these estimates, however, the data shows that somewhere about 80 to 90% of the teams in any given problem are within the same kind of answer window of values. In the snow case, the density of snow can vary by at least fivefold. Maybe more. A fun extension of this problem would be to ask the students to figure out if the same amount of snow filled the classroom, how deep would the classroom be? So there's lots of ways to extend a YouTube problem. Now we have an idea of what a YouTube problem is. The students have investigated heat transfer with firewalkers, reverse engineered how it's made videos from other online sites, and many, many more. There have been hundreds of problems written by my students over many, many years, and we hope these videos will inspire you to create your own creative visual YouTube problems. Stay tuned for other episodes about creating visual, innovative problems for engineering, science, and other STEM fields, all under the theme of reverse engineering education.